Welcome back to MadMan Review, with an episode about the best cartridge for lever-action rifles. I know there are a lot of numbers going through your head right now. There's the 4570, 460 Smith & Wesson Magnum, 500 Smith & Wesson Magnum, and whatever else down to just the 327 Federal Magnum or 22 Long Rifle. However, we are not going to look at these mostly revolver cartridges. We will focus on the ones made for rifles. This includes the 4570, but also the 300 Savage, as well as the 30-30 Winchester. We will not judge them by popularity. In that, the 30-30 Winchester would probably downright win, and the 4570 would be a solid second place. No, instead, we will look at their characteristics to see which one really beats the other. Lever-action rifles come to us from the time of the Wild West. They were simple to operate and reliable when needed. With a lever, the breech is open, the spent cartridge is ejected, and a new one inserted into the chamber. That is not only simple enough, it also does not rely on the power of the round to function. In other words, the rounds can be weak or strong. The action just cycles because the shooter actuates it. This simple system does come with a downside or two. One was the pressure it could withstand. However, the locking bolts got improved over time, so that they closed the breech as strongly as other types of rifles. For example, bolt actions. The other one is the tubular magazine. And don't get me wrong, these magazines have a lot going for them. Not least that they lend themselves to top-up loading, and they are not detachable. That makes them immune to most laws of today that are going against so-called assault weapons by, among other things, limiting ammo capacity of the detachable magazines. The big downside of a tube magazine is that the rounds are stacked one by one after each other. This makes the nose of the second round resting against the primer of the first one, and so, on the whole length of the magazine down, the recoil one shot could send a pointy nose well into the primer of the round in front, and create a chain reaction in which all rounds in the magazine go off. This problem can be mitigated. One way is to have only one round in the chamber and one in the magazine. That way, the pointy nose of the rounds does not touch a primer as there are no other rounds in front. Another way is to use rounds with a blunt nose. They do not set up the primer of the round in front when the recoil sets in. But this has its own downsides. Bullets with a blunt nose are not very ballistically efficient. The drag will slow them down rather fast so that they lose a lot of energy with the distance of their travel. Another way to go against that was found by Arthur Savage, who invented a magazine in 1887, in which the bullets were stacked vertically. Later, he went on to create the popular Savage Model 99 with a rotary magazine. Here, the bullets do not rest on the nose to the primer, so that they can be pointed as they want. Even with this idea and rifles with such magazines on the market, it was the Wild West rifles with tubular magazines from Winchester and Marlin that ruled the day. The reasons for that were simple. First, a lot of hunting was done as ranges of less than 150 yards where the ballistic efficiency was not really significant. Second, a lot of these rifles were also offered in the same caliber as the revolvers of the day, allowing for ammo commonality between both. That makes it easier for the shooter who carried a backup revolver and a rifle. Today, hunters like lever-action rifles for their shape and low weight, as well as for the ability to get off some rounds rather rapidly. While doing so, it is the punch that matters more than the reach or precision. This can be easily achieved by blunt-nosed bullets, so that a tubular magazine is still the king of the day in such rifles. Let's start with the 4570, used already by General Custer in the 7th Cavalry at the Battle of the Little Bighorn. It is a strong cartridge that can easily take down the biggest and most aggressive bears. Also, it's used for deer, moose, and elk whenever range is not as much as a concern. The power of the 4570 does come as much as its velocity or ballistic efficiency that keeps such velocity. It is just its mass that is pushed to 2,200 feet per second in the case of the 300 grain bullet, and just wins the day with brute force. There are even heavier bullets and loads on the market, and hand loaders get it up to even 700 grain bullets. Depending on the load, you can get more than 2,000 foot-pounds of energy out of standard ammo, and more than 3,700 foot-pounds out of more hot-loaded rounds. The 30-30 Winchester is no slouch, but does not come into these levels of brute force. It can get a 170 grain bullet up to 2,300 feet per second of speed and around 2,000 foot-pounds of energy, but one big advantage are its rounds with a better ballistic coefficiency. That was possible through a more aerodynamic shape and a flexible tip so that the nose of the bullet does not set off the primer of the round in front. That allows the projectile to retain a lot of energy while moving downrange. It might have less energy at the muzzle, but after a few hundred yards, it has more left of it than the 4570. The 300 Savage went a step further with the rotary magazine of the Savage Model 99. for which it was developed. It can just be pointy. That allows them to get a 150 grain bullet to a speed of 2,600 feet per second and a muzzle energy of 2,300 foot-pounds. While this is below the muzzle energy of a 4570, it just retains that speed and energy much better. Comparing the recoil, it's no surprise that the brute force of the 4570 has also the strongest kick. With a 300 grain bullet going at 1,800 feet per second, the shooter has to withstand a force of 26 foot-pounds on the shoulder. From a 30-30 Winchester, he gets only half that, 13 foot-pounds, than a 170-grain bullet shot at 2,300 feet per second. The 300 Savage kicks a little bit more, but still much less than the 4570. Using a 180-grain bullet at 2,300 feet per second, the shooter gets to feel 15 foot-pounds of recoil energy. Comparing the drop of the bullet, the 4570 goes down like a stone, while the 30-30 Winchester is a little bit better. The 300 Savage outdoes both by far. This means if you're looking for a strong punch at distances of less than 200 yards, the 4570 is your cartridge to go. If you want to have more energy above that distance and less drop, go with the 30-30 Winchester. However, if you really want to do some long-range shooting, the 300 Savage will do your bidding quite perfectly. And there you have it, guys. It depends on what you're going for. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Click on the tab at the subscribe button and the bell button next to it, so you do not miss another episode. And we'll see you again soon.